Hello everybody, I'm Chris at Wolf Ridge Manufacturing. Today is Saturday, April 2nd, and it's a beautiful weather out here in Wisconsin. I've actually got t-shirt on and working outside, getting the skid steer all cleaned up. We've got 200 hours on this JCB 270T skid steer, and just wanted to kind of walk around and do a little review on the things I like about it. And I don't know if there's anything I don't like about it, but we can do a little walk around quick, and we're getting her cleaned up and get it ready to put her back to work. We got some projects going on here this year. We'll be looking at expanding and of course getting some wood processed and ready for fall. And right now I think I'm just gonna get back to washing it up, clean her up, and we'll do a little walk around here and show you some of the things I really like about this machine. Hang tight. Okay, so I spoke a little soon. It's actually a little bit of hail coming down here. But I'm gonna finish washing this up, get some of this dirt out of here, and make sure we're cleaning around the drives on this machine. As you know, dirt's friction. Friction's not good, it wears idlers. The giant drive gear here, I mean, that thing's like an inch and a quarter, inch and a half thick, but good maintenance goes a long ways, and we'll make sure we clean this all out and get ready to go back and get her dirty again. I'm just doing this in the front yard. I just got warm water from the shop here through the hose. No soap or anything, but basically giving her a good rinse and making sure we don't have any excessive wear on these drives. A little bit of rain now, but it's about 45 degrees outside or so, and warm enough where I can, everything's thawed, and I can actually get some of this stuff cleaned up. Got her all greased down, and clean the air filter, check the oil, check the hydraulic oil. See, there's one grease pin I missed that I didn't catch, and that's right up underneath that boom. We'll have to raise the boom up. There's actually, I think, three or four grease circs under the boom that we gotta hit. I know I got two. And there's one right there I missed on the top of that link. All right, so the hail, little hail squall has passed. You can see that dark cloud over there behind me. It's passed now, and the sun's shining. So welcome to Wisconsin in the springtime. But take a look here at our JCB. Why did I buy this? Well, we were clearing the back lot where the Midwest Firewood Frenzy grounds are, and we broke something on, we had a little Cat 247, and needed to be repaired. It was a major repair. It had to have the engine pulled and the flex drive coupler replaced. So I searched around and I really had been liking the looks of the JCBs, and I really love this machine. And it happened to be the only machine that was in stock. It had 19 hours on it. It was a demo unit, and the sticker price I think was $61,000 or something like that. Brand new, full warranty. And I'm really glad I made this decision. I was looking at, a comparable model would be like a Cat 259. I think this one will outlift the Cat 259. This is a 10,000 pound skid steer, and you can pick and carry over 4,000 pounds with it. So that's huge for here. A lot of times in the winter, we're using pallet forks and moving steel bundles around, so we get our bundles in 4,000 pounds. We've got an indoor-outdoor forklift that works pretty well, but if you're on any kind of a slope or icy ground, that forklift can get stuck fairly easily. So this thing was a huge upgrade for us for winter time, and of course plowing snow and doing any dirt work around the shop here. This has been a huge help. We take a look inside the cab here. Nice roomy cab. I've actually got a jug of bar oil and my files and stuff laying on the floor here. It's kind of dirty inside. I'd like to get this cleaned up, but show you the controls and basically the point of view from the operator's position right here. We've got our throttle and a bunch of different controls up on the right side. Our temperature, fuel on the top, and then the on the side over there is our hydraulic temperature. We got on this side over here, we got our AC, fan, heater controls, radio. Well, these are actually lights that come on when we start it up, I believe here. So yeah. So we got our lock and unlock. We got our float controls, and we'll turn this awesome rock music off here for a minute. We got our high flow controls and stuff like that over here. You can go to ISO controls or an old style controls on the sticks. Of course, on the sticks here, we've got multifunction sticks. We've got, I forget what all these buttons do, but basically you got your high speed, your two speed travel, and then you got control here for your standard auxiliaries. This here, you'd hold the lever down and click this button on the top here to lock in standard flow. You got your high speed right here for travel. This one I haven't really used this one much, or these two here. But this side over here, we use all those buttons on that side for running like a multifunction skid steer attachment. So other than that, let's see, we got, I'll turn this off for a minute. 204 hours on it right now. And I've been really, really happy with it. Nice big door here, get in and out. Of course, that's got a shock and a sliding window here. One thing I will say, if you're running this on a sunny day, wear your sunscreen, because there's glass everywhere, and it's really lots of room for sunshine to come through. Listen to that baby purr. So right down here is our hydraulic oil, engine oil, fuel filter, oil filter. Everything's right, nice and easy to access. You got a hydraulic oil shut off right there. You got a battery shut off there. And then your coolant, air filter. Something about washing every 50 hours. You got a grease circuit here, one down there, one up here, one on the back side of the boom there, one on underneath the boom there, and there. One underneath the boom here, I forgot that one. One up top here. One right here. One right there. And one on the opposite side, that here. And one thing that, you know, got a lot of guys say about this boom being on one side only, you know, they're worried about it bending or lifting uneven, or, you know, worried about twisting something. This thing is super heavy duty. You know, everything's like half inch plate, 3/8 plate, 3/4 plate. You know, this stuff down here, that's all 1 inch plate. And this boom is way heavier duty than anything I've seen on a skid steer. That's probably 3 times heavier duty than the arms on the cat, if not more. I mean, this is all really super heavy duty stuff. So, and I've taken and pulled stumps out of the ground with that machine and basically skimming along, you know, 3-4 miles an hour with a land plane and just plow right into a stump. And I haven't tweaked or bent or broken a single thing on this machine. It's super stout. So if you're looking at a machine like this, I definitely suggest going out and trying it out, because it is a beast. All right, so guys, so that's our review. The only thing I've had to have done on this machine was the water separator. The sensor for the water separator was acting up. And so the tech at the JCB dealer, he gave me his cell phone number. He said, just text me. And if you need anything, just text me and I'll come over and fix it. So it's like, well, that's awesome, you know. How many places do that, where they give you their personal cell phone number. Hey, just text me anytime and we'll get you on the schedule to get something repaired. And of course they came out here and they did the repair, no charge. And I think that was like, I don't know, 30, 40 hours in. It was just a little sensor that needed to be replaced. It was putting it in limp mode. And he came out here the next day, took a walk around, did that replacement on the sensor, checked out the hydraulic oil, kind of looked over the machine, made sure everything else was working good. And I've been super happy with it. So if you're in the market for a new skid steer, definitely check out the JCB. And thanks so much for watching, guys. We'll get some more videos coming up. And I've took a trade in from a customer an attachment that this thing runs really well. And we'll have that coming up in a video pretty soon. And of course, we'll have our 10K giveaway coming up pretty soon. We're almost to 10,000 subscribers. And it'd be really nice to give something away. Thinking maybe a really good chainsaw to go with your Wolf Ridge splitter. So thanks so much for watching. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and have a great day, guys. Thank you.